Hi, I'm Tony Tony, the creator of the Ecotarian Revolution and author of the Ecotarian Diet. My Ecotarian journey started about 33 years ago when I got sick and almost died. I was in an isolation room for about 7 days with IVs going through my veins 24/7. And what they basically said after about day 7 is that if my white blood count didn't go back up by morning, that I probably wasn't gonna make it. That some viral bacterial infection, some germ was basically threatening to take my life. And they were using antibiotics to try to rid this germ. So what happened is that my real estate broker came in and basically said, Tony, if I were you, I would check myself out of man's hospital and into nature's hospital where nature can heal you from the inside out. So we started talking about Hippocrates and how Hippocrates, the father of medicine, used food as medicine and not drugs. Then he handed me some papers that started talking about Pasteur and the germ theory and how Pasteur believed that the human cell was the elementary unit of life. But what he discovered later is that someone by the name of Beauchamp said, no, that there is a tinier organism inside of the human body, tinier than the human cell. And those tiny, tiny organisms were there by the trillions. And he named those microzymas. Now, I had no idea what a microzyma was. But what these papers basically said is that these microzymas begin to morph, or they begin to change their form if there is what he called potentially harmful material. So what they basically do is they basically morph into a more pathogenic type of a bacteria in order to consume that potentially harmful material because it's trying to save your life. But in the end, it is taking your life. So it's kind of like the good, the bad, and indifferent of these microzymas. Again, they are created to help us. They're helpful, but they can turn into harmful if there's harmful material to be consumed. So the number one reason that I am so for us eating, according to nature's circadian rhythms, is it gives the human body time to assimilate the foods that we eat and to eliminate any kind of food particles that was not digested. Then we begin to consume food again. Then we begin to eliminate foods again. We begin to assimilate the foods. And if we don't follow those cycles, guess what? Our digestive system becomes taxied. We become overrun with these potentially harmful bacterias, and they can become so pathogenic that they do have the potential to take our life. So what I would like to say from here on out, if you can just take a look with me at going ecotarian and following nature's circadian rhythms, because I truly believe that it's one of the most important things you can do for the health of your body and for the health of your planet. Thank you so much for joining me, and welcome again to the Ecotarian Revolution. And I really and truly pray that your journey will be as powerful and will be as helpful for you as it was for me.